Yes, sir, but it's not in the house, though.
Good morning, welcome to your fiscal board. It's 9:30 on April the 1st, happy April Fool's Day. And we're moving in. Our agendas are on, our agendas are right on the right bench. And let me repeat our, how we expedite our business. Citizens will have 3 minutes to speak, as we have been doing here lately. Uninterrupted, fiscal board members will then have the opportunity to comment. And then lastly, citizens will have 1 minute to rebuttal. Is Brother Eddie Maynard here from Brooks Baptist Church? No, he's not. Stanley, would you like to lead in a prayer, or Mayor Ricketts? Stanley, let's stand, and Stanley, lead in a prayer and pledge.
Heavenly Father, we ask your blessings on each and every person serving on the board. We ask that you might keep them safe, and not do anything to keep this person from you. Do with the fiscal court members that each decision they might, I think, benefit their friends and neighbors. Above all, please and do, we ask that you keep each and every one of them safe on the way home, Lord. We ask this in Jesus' name.
I pray allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you so much, Stanley. Magistrates, in your packets are the bills for approval. The bills are, action is requested on the bills. I need the bill to be ready.
Thank you, Marsha, for the bill.
Thank you.
Sir.
Thank you. We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Ms. Branson, may I call the vote?
Ms. Axelrod?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Glassman?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carries.
Ms. Sharp, the bills from Treasury's office.
Send the bills from Treasury's office, ready for March 20th, for your approval.
Thank you, Marsha, for taking the bills from Treasury's office.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Ms. Branson, may I call the vote?
Ms. Axelrod?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Glassman?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carries.
Thank you, Ms. Sharp. Action is requested on the approval of the minutes from March the 18th, 2014.
I would do the minutes now, call the board today, and she's going to... I make a motion to approve the minutes as they have been changed.
I'll second that.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? And Ms. Branson, may I call the vote?
Ms. Axelrod?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Glassman?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
At this time, something very exciting is going to happen, and I'm moving these agenda items up to this point in the agenda. It's a very exciting time in the history of Willow County, because right now, some documents are going to be run through fiscal court, action is going to be requested. And this is concerning the 43 acres of land that the Willow County Fiscal Court owns that people like to see have a college still on it. So at this time, can it hurry the rest? Is there any, should these documents be presented in a certain order?
Just the resolution and then these two amendments.
Okay.
Do you have some background on this, Judge?
Well, as of the magistrate, I'm clear on it.
John Spainpower was my office, Mark Staff, he and me also on the board. I know you're here somewhere.
I'm from there.
Okay, sorry. And I think John Snyder was going to be here.
And Bill Duffy.
And Bill Duffy.
He's at the corporation.
Gary Scott's here also.
They weren't at our meeting last week, but that's why I called the folks I know I talked to. This resolution was originally drafted by an attorney that was retained by EDA to prepare the initial documents. What has happened as this has gone on, the outlook, the goal that you talked to the director of the county has expanded. And so we need to go back and fix the resolution to take the direction that they believe the property is taking now, to make sure we don't have to amend it later. My concern was when it wants to start drafting deeds and getting into contracts and then go back and amend the resolution later. So we think we summed this up where it can all be done first, because all the documents will be referred to the deed in any future transaction. We wanted to make sure the resolution is not back.
Thank you, Mayor. Action is requested on the resolution, or if there are questions, feel free to ask. After we take action on the resolution, we kind of run which documents you go second.
The deed, the general warranty deed, and then the agreement. Or I guess it really doesn't matter, Judge. They both reference each other, and they're both referenced in the resolution. All of the resolution goes first. It's whatever order the court rules in.
That would be the purpose of the law. Thank you, John.
Commonwealth of Kentucky, Bullock County, Resolution 14-02, amended resolution of the fiscal course of the county of Bullock, Kentucky, ratifying the creation of the Bullock County Education Development Corporation for the purpose of enabling the corporation to develop and finance the cost of public improvements to enhance educational development in public projects for the county through the issuance of said corporation revenue bonds secured by special authorities pursuant to the open company plan for financing and designated the incorporated said corporation. Whereas it was and is deemed advisable and appropriate for the county of Bullock, Kentucky, to acquire, improve, construct, erect, equip, furnish, and finance projects to enhance the educational development of the county and the surrounding areas, including but not limited to the development of a campus post-secondary educational facility or facilities, the project, and other public buildings and public projects related thereto, which shall be a public project beneficial to the citizens and residents of the county through the holding company plan of financing of type approved by the Supreme Court of Kentucky in Baker versus County of Lexington, Kentucky, 273 Southwest 2nd, and whereas the fiscal court has ratified the adopted articles of incorporation of the corporation to be known as the Bullock County Education Development Corporation, and such corporation has been registered and created as a holding company for the purpose of undertaking the development of the project and the issuing of bonds necessary to finance the project, and whereas the fiscal court has designated the incorporators of the corporation to establish the corporation in accordance with Kentucky law, now therefore the fiscal court does hereby resolve as follows. Section 1, authorization of creation of non-profit holding companies. That the creation of a separate non-profit, non-stop corporation to be known as the Bullock County Education Development Corporation as an agency of the county, which corporation is proposed to be incorporated pursuant to the provisions of the Kentucky Non-Profit Corporation Act set out in Section 273.161-273.390 and Section 58.180 of the Kentucky Revised Statute is hereby authorized and ratified. Section 2, corporation authorized to proceed with financing. Corporation shall proceed as an agency and instrumentality of the county under the holding company plan of financing described in the preamble here to pursuant to KRS 58.180 and to develop the project and to issue, sell, and deliver the necessary amount of its bonds and or notes in one or more series of bonds secured by the revenues of and by the means against the project bonds in order to develop and defray the costs of the project. Section 3, conveyance of property. The county will execute one or more deeds to the corporation conveying the land and properties, the property upon which the project is to be located and constructed, thus deeds being the form approved as set out in the deed attached as Exhibit A, subject to the reconveyance agreement approved the form approved as set out in the deed attached as Exhibit B. Section 4, encumbrances and security for the bonds. That the corporation may, from time to time, lease, mortgage, encumber, assign, grant a security interest in, option, convey, or transfer the property in order to develop and finance the project and to carry out the purposes of this resolution. 5. County judge executive authorized to sign all necessary documents. That the county judge executive be and is hereby authorized on behalf of the fiscal court to execute any and all documents necessary to the effect of this resolution. Section 6, Bullock Fiscal Court Resolution 13-16 is amended. Resolution 13-16 is amended to conform with this resolution. Adopted on April 9, 2014. Signature for Carol J. Roberts. contact with our deputy town clerk.
All right, I make a motion that we approve this document. Wait a second.
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Ms. Brandon, we call the vote.
Ms. Axelrod?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Glassbow?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carries.
The next document is the deed. County attorney, does that need to be written?
I don't believe so, no. The record, if you want it, if you want to read it, there's nothing that you can.
Well, legally, it doesn't need to be written.
No, it can be written in the record. You've already stated what it is for the county attorney.
Okay. Action. Action is requested on the deed.
This deed has a new legal description. It is now accurate. It was provided by John St. Clair. So we have a very definite description of the entire property in question.
I make a motion to accept the deed as written and authorize the judge to sign.
I'll second that motion. Thank you, magistrates. We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? Ms. Brown, we call the vote.
Ms. Axelrod?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Glassbow?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carries.
And the agreement. Action is requested on the agreement.
I make a motion to accept the agreement as written and authorize the judge to sign.
I second that motion.
Thank you, magistrates. We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion? And Ms. Brandon, we call the vote.
Ms. Axelrod?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Glassbow?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carries.
I want to invite the Floyd County Education Development Corporation members to join us up here on this report. You can join behind us. I'd like a photo. I'd like to have a picture made or taken of this very historic event.
Thank you.
I'll say it was 2:45, you know, but it's 2:30. I started the registration up.
They are.
There must be the people up there. They don't take that from me.
Okay, next on the agenda, let's have Sheriff Dave Greenwell talk about the HIV he's collected. Deputy Curry, good morning, dude. Doing well, good to see you.
The months of January and February for the HIV program, total number of hookups for January were 12. Nine of those were in-county hookups and three were out-of-county hookups. That was a total of $675. The the total fees for the month collected for the daily fees and the out-of-county fees was $7,269. Total expenses to Corusoft was $1,760. The BCSO distribution portion was $2,855. Of that, hookup fees was $1,355, and the daily monitoring was $1,100. The total fiscal court distribution was $1,299. That was for the month of February. The month of February, we had a total of 10 new hookups placed into the program. All of those were in county. That was a total of $500. The total monthly receipts for the daily fees was $6,863. The expense to Corusoft was $1,744. The distribution for the sheriff's office was $2,615. The total distribution out to the fiscal court was $1,118.
Thank you, Dr. Curry. Any questions about the HIP score? Please, thank you.
$145,000 to save. You want to do it to the other?
I'll second.
We have a motion and a second. Any questions or discussion?
They say $43.
Ms. Grant, will you please have motion?
To accept Mango's bid for blacktop at $41.72 per ton for base blacktop and $43.22 per ton for surface blacktop.
Any questions or discussion? Ms. Grant, you may call the roll.
Ms. Ashcraft?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Blackwell?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carried.
For your all general information, we're saving quite a bit of money for doing the bidding process for the companies. The state contract this season is $52.75 a ton. So we're doing the bidding, we're saving $9.53 a ton, which means that you'll be able, we'll be able to put down over $190,000 more in the black segment. And that is the estimated number that we've got to pay for the money in what's in progress. And that's all I've got. If y'all have anything for me. Thank you all, appreciate it.
Thank you, Director. Director Bill, emergency services.
Thank you, ma'am.
I have before you all this morning the recommendation to hire Amanda Sellers, Communications Division, as a full-time employee at $12 per hour. This will fill one of the two open positions that we had at the center. Yes.
I make a motion that we hire Amanda, is it Siller or Sellers? Amanda Siller.
I'm guessing, Judge. I need to talk to Carla, she can go.
Okay. At a full-time, let's see, the position was a budgeted position that was approved in the 2013-2014 budget. The starting salary will be $12 per hour, and I make that motion based upon the recommendation of Director Phillips. Thank you, Minister. We have a motion and a second. Ms. Grant, you want to read that motion, please?
The motion is to hire Amanda Siller at EMS at the Communications Division at $12 per hour full-time based on recommendation by the Director Phillips.
Yeah, that's it. Any questions or discussion on the motion? Ms. Grant, you may call the roll.
Ms. Ashcraft?
Yes.
Mr. Hunt?
Yes.
Mr. Blackwell?
Yes.
Mr. Bradshaw?
Yes.
Ms. Roberts?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Thank you.
Thank you. For me, I'm going to go back to the North End and wait around and see what I got to be with the environmental.
Director Matt, this is all right. Cleanup day is, and that's passed. Good morning, Director. Cleanup day is very popular.
Pardon?
Cleanup day is very popular. I already had several people ask me.
Yeah, that's the question I have. This bid. Urban bid. We are 54. The discrepancy that I'm having is
if you look at Rumpke's bid, the bid cost of delivery on empty containers was $95. If I add the 95 to the 425, it's still the lower bid. But the bid was advertised on full containers. Bids will be accepted on full containers only. Disposal rate per ton, transportation cost, and fuel charge must be included in the full container cost. Always must go to certified landfill. Company must furnish driver tickets for each load per location. And then the rest is just where you submit it. And then it says down at the bottom, bulletproof report reserves the right to accept and or reject any or all bids in whole or part. The problem that I ran in with this, and the reason that I changed the bid this year to full containers only, is because when there may be three containers at two locations, six containers that they brought out that they charged us $95 for. So to try to keep the empties from the fulls and the half fulls, then I just bid full containers. So my question is, can I accept Rumpke's bid adding the 425 plus the 95? Or can I accept their bid if they want to do it 425 per full container?
Your add was from full containers.
Full containers only.
So it's 425 for Rumpke, it's 625 for Rumpke.
Okay. Should I ask Rumpke while they're here if they want to do it?
That's what their bid says.
Right. What their bid says.
Their bid says 425.
Right.
Why do you think they change that?
Well, I think Carol.
Yeah, our intention on the bid would be the 95 and the 425 together. Because we deliver like 10 containers, I think we did the project last year.
Yeah, it is.
They're delivered empty and that's one fixed. You don't, when we remove them, if they're empty, that's all you pay.
The bid was for full container home. So right. If you're stating, I got this right, Rumpke is $520 then. And Echo Tech is $625.
That's, yes.
Yes.
We're okay with that.
That's what your bid's for.
Okay. I know, I'm different. I was just.
Compared to the other.
Okay, I got you. Okay, then all I need is a motion to accept.
Okay, Rumpke is $520.
Correct.
$425 plus $95. Echo Tech is $625.
That is correct.
Is that right? I see you are.
Yeah, the only thing I have to say is I don't think this drunk is going to be responsible. If you ask for the bids a certain way and then you can accept it, yep. Show that right, do what you want to do.
The next last sentence is bulletproof this report reserves the right to accept and or reject any and or all bids in whole or part. If Rumpke's here saying that's their figure for the two numbers together, I think the court would consider it. I understand what you're saying, but the choice is theirs.
It's going to cost you more money. You can accept Rumpke's different order, but I go ahead and take the 95% because you're only going to get it. Instead of paying $5.25 for every container, I would only pay the $4.25 for the full.
You might want to come up here to the microphone so it's recorded.
I wouldn't care if you do the
It's the these folks vote, okay?
Well, what I'm trying to explain to you is if you combine the 95 to the 25 of every container, you're going to be paying that for every container. The 95 only comes in at the end of the day, they've got two or three different containers set there that they haul on the way. So if we have 30 loads, for example, on that day, from that place to the port, and we go ahead and pay the $5.25, you're going to be paying $100 for the container. And you only have to have three entries at the end of the day, and you can get the price for it on the way.
But we would have paid $95 if it was delivered.
No, what they're saying is, at the end of the day, it's at 4 o'clock, and they had extra containers there to service the people. I'm doing this for y'all, man. And you've got two containers, two full, two empty. They're going to charge you $4.25 for the full, and $9.5 for the two empty.
Actually, no, that was staying on the record, it's under at 20%
delivery. It's $9.5 when we take them out. It's no fee.
They're right.
See, we include all that on here.
That's what I'm saying. The bid is $5.20 for a full container. That's what you did, that you just said that they were putting on there. Your bid for a full container is $6.25. This report does not have to take the lowest bid. What feels that it should take the other bid for a reason. The 95 in my mind scenario is really relevant to paying $5.20 for a container. They're paying.
No,
here's
no,
the
no, delivery out.
Delivery out. Specifically state.
Yes. Everything there. Yes. Yes. Thank you. I wasn't sure, and I work with both these companies. Both these companies are highly reputable companies. It's just easier for us that I know when that container leaves, I'm charged $400, $500, $600. Trying to keep up, it saved us money the last two or three years. So that's why I did it that way. Sometimes when you've got trucks running in and they're dropping the empties and they're grabbing the pulls, and there's times we've had two or three trucks doing two or three different things at two or three different locations, I can't be in all three locations or two locations. So I try to come up with a way that this thing is the paperwork straight. Well, I'm responsible for it. But it's all said and done. So you all will go ahead and make a motion to accept what I'm giving. I'll go ahead on that work. And I just need the okay to put it in the paper.